you've been well, you've been indoors practicing social distancing. Well, yeah, one thing I mean wanted to express was hopefully you guys have been applying your common sense and, you know, have been propagating common sense to others as well. I mean, yesterday there was this, we were supposed to express our gratitude to all those who been risking their lives and, you know, been at it and been doing their job for our sake. You know, a simple thank you from our houses, from our windows, from our balconies, but people just went crazy and, you know, I saw crazy number of videos where people have taken out rallies and, you know, they're in their groups. I mean, just crazy. And as a responsible citizen, I hope you've been, you know, trying to get this message across to people and, you know, propagating common sense more than anything else. Anyways, another thing, obviously tough times, but, you know, hopefully you've been moving around in your houses, being active, being doing something or the other, developing a new skill, and this is a great time to do that. Rather than, you know, just binge watch all the 24 hours. Right, so yeah, yesterday was Sunday, I just went a little crazy and, you know, kind of finished four workouts in one shot for about 2 hours or so. Let me just show you.
Yeah, that's what I was up to yesterday. But anyways, so yeah, here we are today. So let's continue with a quick workout.
I mean, from your homes, from wherever you are indoors, right? Let's do a very quick workout. Okay, we'll do a four-time workout, as in we'll develop a circuit and we'll try to complete 8 rounds as fast as possible, right? Speed is the parameter there. Of course, form and everything maintained, alright? So we'll do a simple thing. We'll do side punches, we'll do straight kicks, and we'll do jumping jacks. 10, 10, 10, and we'll do this for about 8 rounds, okay? So that's the workout. Let's start off with our warm-ups.
Six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Spot jobs. But yeah, what else has been on? I mean, what skills have we been practicing or trying to learn? What else interesting have you seen or come across in the last couple of days, a few days? Do type in. It'll be interesting to know your thoughts as well. So yeah, keep moving, just warm up a little. Get your heart beating a little faster. Interesting philosophies or any interesting aspects of human nature that you would have come across. It would be interesting to know. Like, now that you're at home and you're spending so much time with your close ones, right? Or you have a lot of time introspecting and, you know, thinking about so many things. What's so interesting or something that kind of struck a chord or you really started thinking about it or something that was amusing? It will be amazing to know. All right. So let's start off with our main workout. So we'll do side punches, front kicks, and jumping jacks. 10, 10, 10 for about 8 rounds, alright? And let's see how quickly we'll finish this workout. Now, I'll just give you a quick demo in terms of the main workout that we're doing. So, legs straight out, facing forward. Hip width apart, hands up, and we'll do our side punches. Basically, pivot to one side. So let's say to the left with your right punch, come back and pivot to the right with your left punch. Right? right. Okay, so that's side punches. And now front kicks. So your leg stays as straight as possible and try to kick as high as possible. Alright? So we'll do 10 right kicks followed by 10 left kicks. Alright? And then, of course, your begins. Alright? Cool. So simple, no equipment needed. We're practicing minimalism, right? So whatever little space that you have at your place, whatever little space that you have at your place. Sufficient, no equipment required. Alright, so let me just quickly time myself. So you guys can time yourselves and definitely let us know your time to complete the workout. Okay, so 8 rounds, 10 side punches, 10 front kicks, followed by 10 jumping jacks. So when I say side punches, 10 left, 10 left and 10 right. And when I say 10 front kicks, 10 right and 10 left. And 10 jumping jacks, all right? Okay, let's begin. 3, 2, 1, go.
Third round, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5,
7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, last round. So, Mushmi, a very cardio-based workout, right? So, works a lot for your cardio, for your core, for your glutes, your leg muscles. So, yeah. So, probably you can just do one shot of it. So we finished one workout. So you could repeat this again. It's just been 9 minutes, right? So you might want to do one more if you're up for it, or you might want to do two more if you're up for it, and see what's the difference in terms of time, right? So the first round, let's say for example, I finished in 9 minutes. So the second round, I might be a lot more pumped, so probably I might just complete it in 8 minutes 30 seconds. And let's say for the third round, or rather the third circuit, I might be a little fatigued, so I might just take a little extra time. Anyway, so yeah, just give it a shot for 3 workouts. So I'm not going to do the cool down, so I'll do one more workout. But yeah, you guys can continue and or you can stop and finish your cool down. Very important. So yeah. But yeah, guys, these are really testing times, and I know it's really, really frustrating to be sitting indoors, and it's just a lot more frustrating to have no choice of going out. On a normal day, we would love if there was a holiday, right? If we had like 5 days to laze around and do nothing, we would love it. We would binge watch and just not crib about it. But because there's an imposition, or there's a compulsion, it's human nature, and we ought to resist it, right? But my 2 cents to you would be to practice discipline in this time, and that discipline will kind of help you sail through this period of time. And in fact, it might just make you a lot more better in terms of your overall outlook, in terms of your overall personality. Follow a few things. Write down 5 or 6 pointers that you will do every day. Let's say, for example, I would suggest you get up on time, a little early in the morning, probably by 6 or 7. Do not miss that. Get up, make your bed, clean up your stuff, freshen up, walk out in the morning if you like to. I mean, that'll be a good thing as well. If you're working from home, give it your best, finish all your work online or whatever work you're doing, that is. Make sure you definitely make some time and learn a new skill. I mean, that will be the defining thing that you do during these times. I can't fail to emphasize on this particular point. Learn something new, or probably something new that you had given up. I mean, let's say, for example, you love music and you know, you learned to play guitar a while back, but you haven't been practicing. This is the best time to take that guitar out, or whatever musical instrument, or whatever it is, right? I mean, some of you have been messaging and saying that, you know, you've been sketching, some of you have been baking. I mean, that's amazing. I mean, you just need to harness that skill, and you know, that's something that will define you and it'll take you through. So, my advice would be to, you know, have like 4 or 5 things to do in a day. Follow that routine very judiciously, and it should help you a lot. Alright, so that's it from me. I'll see you soon.